What if ChatGPT could do more than answer questions? What if it could not only propose solutions to those questions, but also create workflows to solve real problems?
It's happening! It's happening!
Well, that's exactly what Hugging Face's paper has proposed. A viable way to allow large language models to create workflows that can handle surprisingly complex problems. So let's dive into the paper and see what it has to say. It talks about the current weaknesses of generative AIs, namely that they're currently limited to text as both an input and an output format, and that they struggle with composing solutions to tasks with multiple subtasks, and that the general models do not perform as well as the fine-tuned models on specific tasks. What Hugging Face proposes is to use large language models not only as an interface to connect specialized AI models, but how to kind of piece them together to get an output. This would come in the form of providing the LLM a prompt, such as, can you describe what this picture depicts and count how many objects are in the picture? And the model will devise the task planning, the model selection, the task execution, and finally, the response generated to you as the user.
Mind blowing. Like, I don't even think, I think that it will hit me like in 5 years.
The process begins with the task planning phase, with the user providing a prompt for what they would like to solve. This request is broken down into a series of subtasks, which the large language model would need to create a set of task dependencies and the execution order. This would support both specification-based instructions and demonstration-based instructions. Where specification-based instructions would be requests like, read this email and summarize it, while demonstration-based instructions would be more akin to training, where both the request task and an example response are provided. For example, something like, I would like to create a process that responds to emails in my style, while providing some sample emails you've gotten and your responses. This kind of in-context learning can help empower the generative model to create systems more aligned with your vision and how it should work. The paper provides some examples of different tasks with their expected inputs. There are quite a few possible task combinations, including image to text, text to speech, and really dozens of others, as we can see here. After the large language model has determined the task list, the next phase of Hugging GPT is to begin the model selection process, leveraging the descriptions of various models in the Hugging Face library. The LLM would decide which models would best fit which subtask. For example, if one of the subtasks is to determine what animals are present in an image, it would try to select the model that best performs for that task. Now, a limitation of this approach for the moment is that every task is viewed as self-contained. While many problems in the real world require a complex set of interactions, right now, specialized AI models can really only handle specific tasks really well.
It's very simple, and I think that's how you should do things in life.
This does limit how complex our problems can be, though even being able to propose this is kind of phenomenal. Next, the model determines how these tasks should be executed and their dependencies on one another. For example, when asking about what animals and plants are present in the image, the model could run those tasks simultaneously, since they're independent of one another. While a task for converting a response to an input to speech would have task dependency. Gotta create the speech first, or the text rather, and then convert it to speech. The paper does point out a problem area for the model, which is planning future tasks that are dependent on future results. For example, if an image contains a human, we should try to identify who they are. And if it doesn't, there's no need to identify. For this particular problem, the model proposes the resource tag, which can help the model determine future non-deterministic tasks. At this point, the model will collect its result and present the answer to the requester. This will include not only the requested output, but also present the steps the model took to solve the problem. The following example given in the paper is quite telling, with perhaps the most interesting portion being that not only does the model understand how to put this process together, It also understands how to present this process to the user in a meaningful and structured way. This is really incredible, and I believe it does show that we are truly coming closer to something that resembles general artificial intelligence. I can think of several tasks this could help to automate for my life, for example, replying to simple technical support issues, where a simple process should be followed. Perhaps something like restarting a process on a server, or giving someone documentation to solve a particular programming problem. What do you think it could be used for? Let us know in the comments. And if this was informative and helpful, please like and subscribe.